Okay, so we're back. I just took a quick drink real quick. We're on part 10. I can't believe this is the fifth part of this recording session. I thought I'd be doing three like the last time, but I'm doing five. Sori's room is as messy as it's always been. Oh, I have my... Hopefully I didn't stop recording. I also recognize the same stuffed animals and wall directions that she had for years now. If you came over more often, it wouldn't be such a mess. That's because I end up cleaning it for you. How could you suddenly want to come over today? Aren't you supposed to be to see Natsuki today? Yeah, but... Wait, how did you know that? Sori had already left by the time we decided the last meeting. Monica told me. It's only natural for me to keep me informed about the festival preparations, right? That's true. But what about you? Are you going to be helping Monica today? Of course. But I'm just helping her online. We didn't plan to meet up or anything. So it's just me and Natsuki then. Yep. There's more silence between us. Sarah's at a random direction. Everything about her behavior is really uncharacteristic. I finally get to the point. I just wanted to see how you were doing. After you left on Friday, when something wrong, you can't hide it from me. Something's wrong, you can't hide it from me. I know you too well. So, Sori smiles, shakes her head. That's no good, Deacon. Eh. Why can't it just be like it's always been? This is all my fault. If I didn't get so weak and accidentally express my feelings, if I didn't make that stupid mistake, then you wouldn't have been worried about me at all. You wouldn't have come over. You wouldn't have been thinking about me right now. But this is just my punishment, isn't it? Getting punished for being so selfish. I think that's why the world decided to have you come over today. It just wants to torture me. Sori. Grab Sori by the shoulders. What on earth are you saying? Are you listening to yourself right now? I know something happened to you. There's no other explaining for you to be like this. So tell me already. Till now, I won't be able to stop thinking about it. Sori gives me an empty smile. You really put me in a trap, Deacon. But you're wrong. Nothing happened to me. I've always been like this. You're just seeing it for the first time. Seeing what? What are you talking about, Sori? You're really just going to make me say it, aren't you, Deacon? I guess I have no choice this time. The thing is, I've had really bad depression my whole life. Did you know that? Why do you think I'm late to school every day? Because most days I can't even find a reason to get out of bed. What reason is there to do anything when I fully know how worthless I am? You're not worthless. I hate people that say that. Why go to school? Why eat? Why make friends? Why make other people put their energy and cares to waste by having them to spend it on me? That's what it feels like. And that's why I just want to make everyone happy. This brings back memories. I kind of felt that way back in college, back before college. I still go through it daily, but more today in like the last couple months, it's more easy to actually handle depression. It's really easy to handle it now, but back in college and high school, it is very bad. It is very bad. College, I almost broke. And I had to go see a therapist. And if I didn't oversleep because I didn't want to get up some days, I just wanted to sleep all day because I felt worthless every single day. I would have kept seeing that therapist, but I stopped because I stopped seeing it. I really wanted to continue seeing it, and I don't think he'll see this, but my father told me, if you really wanted to see a therapist, you miss days, blah blah blah. Yeah, that's because you don't know how it is. I felt worthless to anybody, so even getting up and going there was hard for me to even let go. And then him saying, you didn't want going there, you didn't get up for those times, you didn't do that, it's hard. If he wouldn't have said that and they would have let me go there a couple more times, I would have loved it. I would have loved going to your therapist. I would have loved it. It's easier to handle now, but back then, if I could have gone there a couple more times, at least once every so often, it would have really helped, because I really hit low. I hit a really low point. And this is before I really picked up YouTube as my thing. This was still in the in-between phases, and it's hard. It's hard for me to see people like this. It's hard to go back and look at myself. I try to hide these memories deep inside, but they make their way out, and I have to talk about them. If I don't talk about them, they're gonna fester and build, and then it's gonna explode inside me, and that won't be good, so I will talk about it. But if I could go back, I would force myself out of that bed. Those 2 days I missed, I would have forced myself out. I would have went to therapy. I would have done it, because that was my relaxing time to talk about it. But it was hard, because every time, even talking to friends, I didn't talk to friends a lot, because I just felt worthless. I felt entirely worthless in my anime club. I felt entirely worthless just going and talking or going to classes. I almost completely flunked out my first semester just because how worthless I felt. So, I didn't go back. I didn't go back to therapy my second semester. Actually, was it? I think it was my second semester. Actually, I think it was my second semester. It's not even my first. My first, I was feeling. No, it was my first semester because the police car. If I would have chose to go back, I really should have gone back the second semester. If I would have went back, I would have said to the therapist to not tell my parents anything, because my father not knowing it would have been the best decision. Because him saying, oh, you didn't show up those 2 days, well, you didn't care enough to actually go. That's not at all. You don't see it like I see it. So, if I go back, I would also go back and say, on those days, I would say to them, don't say anything to my parents. Don't let them know. My friend knows. My best friend knows I've been in the dark times, and she's been a savior to me, more than my family. Just because I can say more to her, because she listens. My family might listen every so often, but they don't. They just ignore it, mostly. So I don't talk about stuff like this anymore with the family. I only talk about it with my friend. It's the only place I can talk about it with. So, sorry, I'm talking too much. This has been going on for too long. Hopefully neither my father or mother sees this, but whatever. It's much better to handle today, so I'm not that much, but seeing Sarori say this in a game, seeing anybody say it, it pisses me off. Even if I don't know you, I see that and I'm like, I try to encourage you. If I see it in chat when someone says it, I try to encourage them, because it's not the way to go. You feel worthless so often, but you can get past it. It just takes time. It took me longer than it should have, but I got past it. I still deal with it every day, but it's easier to deal with right now. I still haven't got to the point where it breaks me. I haven't got to that point since college, back in Cobleskill. And that's why I just wanted to make everyone happy, without anyone worrying about me. I'm in shock. I can't even figure out how to respond. How is it possible that Suri kept this from me the entire time that I've known her? Did she really want so badly for me to just not think about her? Why, Suri? Why is it that you have always never told me about this. It almost feels like I've been betrayed as your close friend. Because if I knew, I would have done everything I could to support you. Even if there's only so much that I could do, I would have tried a little bit harder to make every day a little better for you. That's why I'm your friend. All you had to do was tell me. And you don't understand at all, Deacon. Why do you think I didn't tell you? Because if I told you, then you would have to waste effort caring about me instead of doing important things I don't want to be cared for about. It's bittersweet when people try to care about me. It feels nice sometimes, but it also feels like a bat being swung against my head. That's why I wanted so badly for you. I might just call this episode opening up. Because I'm not cutting that out, I'll leave it in. It's opening up for my chat. Open up for fans. So if you ever see, it's always like if I don't put up a video a day or two, it's me just dealing with it. Because some days it takes a little more than my normal stuff just to deal with depression. So if you ever see a video, it has to be like a 2-day long gap. I'll say something on Twitter. I'll be like, I'm dealing with something right now and I can't do anything today, so sorry about no video, but it's only for today. Might last 2 days or 3 days at max. I want it so badly for you to make friends with everyone else. Helping everyone be happy together is the best thing for me. But then I discover something else too. Seeing you make friends and get closer with everyone is in the club. It feels like a spear going through my heart. So that's why I decided the world just wanted to torture me. Every path led to nothing but hurt. You're right. I don't understand. I don't understand your feelings at all, Suri. But I don't need to understand. Whatever it takes for me to help you stop hurting, that's what I'll do. No, Deacon. There is nothing at all. The only thing that you could have hoped is if everything could be like it was, it always was. But I was selfish. I finally showed you what a horrible person I am. Tears stroke down. Hug her, you idiot. I made you join the literature club because I was selfish. And I was punished by my heart hurting in a way that I couldn't understand. And now you came here and I made you hurt too. I'm just weak and selfish. That's all I am. And that's why I'm going to accept these punishments, because I deserve every last one. Without thinking, I once again grab her. This time I pull her into a tight brace. Deacon, sorry. I don't care if you feel selfish. I'm really happy that you convinced me to join the club. Seeing you every day makes it worthwhile enough. If I make friends with everyone else, that's just a bonus. But please never underestimate how much I care about you. I wouldn't have it any other way. Deacon, Suri isn't hugging me back. Despite my arms being wrapped around her, Suri's arms remain at her side. She's starting sobbing next in my ear. No, don't do this to me. Please don't do this. Deacon. I barely manages to speak between her sobs. I don't know if I'm doing the right thing. You're doing the right thing. All I want is for her to know that I care. If you have it in you to call yourself selfish, then you have to let me be selfish too. No matter what it takes, I'll figure out what needs to change. I'll make these feelings go away. And if there's anything that you need to do, need me to do, then you had better tell me. I'll get mad if you don't. I don't know. Gently, Sori finally puts her arms around me in return. I don't know anything. It's all really scary. I don't understand any of my feelings, Deacon. The only thing I'm not feeling nothing in is when I'm feeling pain. But your hugs are so warm. And that's really scary too. Sori lets go of me. As she does it, so I let her go as well. The festival is tomorrow. Yeah. It's going to be fun, right? Yeah. How would you like for me to spend it all with you? It's what I want. I promise. I think that would be nice then. Yeah. Sori wipes her eyes. If I could spend the whole day here, I would. Of all days, this has to be the one where I have other plans. Maybe I should cancel. No, don't. Please don't. If you do that, then I really wouldn't forgive you. But it's almost time for Natsuki to meet me at my house. At the very least, do you want to come along and help out? It would be fun. To my surprise, Sori shakes her head. I'm sorry. I don't know if that would be very good for me today. You understand, right? It's kind of hard for me to fully understand, but I'm trying my hardest. It's okay. Don't worry too much about it. I'll see you tomorrow, okay? Alright. Look forward to it. I say goodbye to Sori and exit her house. On the way home, I find myself still feeling uneasy, but it's hard for me to keep thinking about it when Natsuki is about to come over too. I think Sori is right. I shouldn't be worrying too much. We're definitely going to have a great time tomorrow. I should just focus on what's ahead of me. I spend only a few minutes back at home waiting for Natsuki's arrival. Before I know it, she texts me, letting me know she's outside the front door. How did I open the front door to let her in? Sup? Hey. I don't know what I was expecting, but seeing Natsuki in something other than her school uniform totally threw me off. Seeing her in such cute clothing make the uniform seem totally unfitting and comforting. Jeez, don't make me feel so awkward already. It's gonna be a long afternoon, so don't be weird just because you're not used to seeing me outside of school. Anyways, I'm coming in. Well, we have a really nice kitchen. I have a really nice kitchen, family. I see you brought a lot of stuff. Carrying a large bag that is probably full of baking supplies. Well, I didn't want to come all the way and find out that your kitchen isn't equipped for the job. You bought everything I asked you to, right? Yeah, I did. Good. Glad I could count on you to do your part. Well, of course. I'm surprised to hear Natsuki suddenly say that, rather than something snarky like she usually does. Could it be that she is a little different outside of school after all? Anyways, let's go to the kitchen. What? You are not even gonna offer to take this heavy bag from me? Where's the hospitality, Deacon? Come on. Since when did I need to be a gentleman? Grab the bag from Natsuki's holding out for me. Urgh. This is ridiculously heavy. Ahaha. I carried that all the way here. Are you impressed? I see now. Yeah, I'm impressed, Natsuki. It seems like I always underestimate you. It's because I'm so small, isn't it? You jerk. Natsuki hits a fist into my chest. Hey. Besides, it has nothing to do with it. Do you really hate being small that much? Eh? It's not like I hate it. I mean, something I like proving people wrong when they only think I'm worth my size. It's fun when I get to be small and also better than other people. But, geez, never mind. What are you making me say? Don't think you can make me talk about weird stuff just because we're not at school. Are we getting started or what? That's a lot of stuff I'm gonna... There's a lot of stuff I'm gonna teach you. Uh-huh. What? That's a little bit more like you. You're more fun when you just speak your mind like that. Hey. Now, are you treating me like a kid? I was just trying to be a little nicer to you, you know? And just because I don't have a mature and sexy figure like Yuri, doesn't mean you shouldn't treat me like... Natsuki catches her words and her face turns red. Natsuki, forget it. I didn't say anything. I should apologize. Huh? Appreciate that you were trying to be nicer. I should have been a little more considerate too. But also, if that's what you're thinking, and you should know that there are tons of guys who aren't into body types like yours. How would you know that anyways? Just trust me on this one. Gross. Hey. Was that to me? Who else? Man. Let's just get this started already. Ahaha. You get all sour when a girl calls you gross. Finally found your weakness, Deacon. Natsuki smiles deviously. Damn it, please spare me. Well, if Natsuki decides to dish out more insults like that, there's no way I'm not fighting back. But she's satisfied enough for now. Finally starts pulling things out of the bag so we can get started. Before long, the kitchen is a mess. Spoon, dairy bowls, flour, spilled flour, and plastic bags are strained about every countertop. The mixer is big enough to make all the batter at once, so we had to do it several times. Meanwhile, Natsuki is babysitting all my movements to make sure I don't mess up her precious bacon. Deacon, where did you put the food coloring? The batter is going to go in the oven soon, so I need to fill the trays. I think it's still in the bag next to the table. What are you using it for? To color the batter in, of course. Making sure... We're gonna finish this conversation, and if it goes black screen again, we're gonna end it there because I laid some stuff on the table, a little bit. Some I should have laid on the table, but I'm not cutting it out. I leave it in because, like I said, this probably won't gain much of any views anyway, so I'm not too worried. I'm not a big YouTuber right now, so if I say stuff like this will be forgotten in time. So I'm more thankful for me being a little YouTuber right now. I'm making each tray a different color. That way, even if the flavors aren't different, everyone can still pick their flavor. Oh, that's a cute idea.
Are we doing anything like that with the icing?
Do you want to? You're asking me? I don't really have a preference, so come on. I'm not putting any heart into this at all. Can you at least try to have fun? I'm having fun. Not really sure what Natsu is trying to get out of me. Meanwhile, I see her separate the batter into smaller bowls and put a few drops of food coloring into each. And that doesn't look pretty cool. I think if I went with Yuri, if I picked Yuri instead of Natsuki at the very end of the day, Yuri would be an even more dishonest because I chose Yuri over Natsuki. See? It's not like baking is just about following instruction. Presentation is where you get to be creative and have most fun. It's a million times more worth it in the end. Just looking at it. Like the ones you made on the first day, huh? Cole proudly presenting her cat-shaped cupcakes, and Sori and Monika delight expression. Wonder if I can make Natsuki proud like that too. Yeah. Maybe I will use food coloring then. Sounds like you're starting to understand. Just make sure you completely finish mixing the icing before you mess with the food coloring. Yeah, it's getting there. We were using the electric mixer for the batter. So I got stuck with a whisk and a huge bowl of for the icing. Eh. The icing's still all lumpy. Are you even trying? Well, yeah. It will just take a little longer. Jeez, I'll be here all night if you do it like that. Here, look. Natsuki grabs the ice from me and uses her hand to tilt the bowl back. You really need to beat the crap out of it. After a few seconds, the icing has already improved. See? Okay, we're gonna save here because she's gonna be talking forever, it seems like.
Which one do I want to get rid of?
Oh, this was the bottom middle one was me deciding somewhere else. Okay, the saves are all messed up. Otherwise, thank you guys so much for watching part 10. This has been me opening up and Sori opening up for me. And now we got Natsuki in the house making stuff with us. We will see Sori tomorrow and hopefully it'll be all fine. Hopefully we can make her feel better over time. I don't know how long this game is. I've been playing, I don't know, probably all together 30 minutes times 5 would be 5 hours in total. So it's a long game, I'll give them that. Otherwise, thank you guys for watching the video. Like I said, if you haven't already subscribed to the channel, I recommend subscribe to the channel, keep up with all the content. I know you guys won't see this. I know you guys probably won't see the beginning of it, but if you do, don't worry about me too much. I've gotten over it. If I really need help, I will go back and see help, but right now I can deal with it. I worry about more about you guys than anything. So if you're feeling down and you need something like that, go and see help. Go and see help or go to a friend. So much easier that way. Otherwise, I'm gonna get emotional again. I'm definitely taking a break before part 11 because I want to try to get some stuff done. Otherwise, like I said, thank you guys so much for watching. Have a good morning, have a good afternoon, have a good night. Or just have a good day. Wherever you are, just have a good day. And I'll see you guys in the next video. After a short break. Peace.